Hey guys, how's it going? And welcome back to another Motivational Mondays. You already know. So, well, today, see, look, I got my hands free. So, I'm gonna see if I can keep the camera a little stiller, a little less movement than usual. So, well, today's Motivational Monday, we're gonna be talking about how to motivate yourself, how to get through the day, how to do what you gotta do when there's a lot of wind and you need a windsock. You know, I don't think I'm ever gonna let go of that joke. It's just too good, too much fun. But in all seriousness, it's just... What are you waiting for, bro? Fuck, man. You know, that's the one thing that I'm never gonna get used to. I know, I'm sorry. I'm already starting the Motivational Monday off a little on the wrong end, but... Yeah, one thing that I'll never get used to, I mean, I'm from Miami, Florida, and I grew up with a lot of tourists, and pretty much everywhere I've lived or everywhere I've been, there's a lot of tourists around, and I like hanging around in areas that are, you know, major areas with a lot of tourists, and yeah, man, just sometimes tourists drive me crazy, but again, I digress. I love tourists. But yeah, no, I was just like, I know it was off camera, you couldn't see it, but there was just like, you know, there was all this traffic, all these cars like waiting, all these people waiting and me waiting, and there was just some guy going slower and slower and slower, and then as soon as he gets close, it's just a tourist, you know, looking for directions, lost, causing accidents. You already know. Okay, so, all right, well, enough of an intro. Let's get back to what you guys are here for, which is your Motivational Mondays. Yeah! All right, well, in today's episode, we're going to do a little bit of a story time, all right? We're going to talk a little bit of story time. And I'm going to tell you guys, I guess, kind of like my own personal story. Because, well, not a personal story that you guys know of. But we're going to see if I can go back in time. Back to a very, very long time ago. Around 3-4 years ago. And we're going to be talking about how I motivated myself to do the things that I'm doing now. Now, the reason we're going to be talking about this today is very simply because, you know, I was just hanging out with my girlfriend literally last night, and we were watching, you know, just YouTube videos, eating shit, you know, with, you know, Netflix and chill, right? YouTube and chill. And I don't know how it came about, but we just started watching a few of my older videos, you know, like back when I was in Seattle, back when I first started, you know, vlogging, when I first started doing this stuff. Man, I hope it's not too windy. I hope you guys can hear me good, because it is kind of windy, but it's nice. So I hope this comes out good. Hope this translates well. It's a mail guy, you see? That's the mail. That's the postal service here. All right, so... Man, it's really windy, man. It's really, really, really windy and loud. I really hope you guys can fucking hear me, man. This really kind of sucks. Now, see, I really do wish I had a windsock. By the way, update on the windsock situation. The reason I really haven't been able to get a windsock for this thing is because I thought it was going to be a lot easier for me to put one on here. But I got, like, this special contraption around my camera, and it's actually not going to be that easy. So stay tuned for more. Maybe my girl can help me create something for this. All right, so let's just get into... You know, again, this is Motivational Monday, right? Seems like I haven't been doing a very good job of motivating you in the last, like, 4 minutes. So, we're going to continue with this and see if we can do a better job for the rest of the video. So, it's story time. You know, I'm going to tell you guys how I motivated myself to, you know, grab this camera and talk to you guys pretty much on a daily basis and walk and talk and do the things that I do. Now, a lot of you guys out there, you know, assume or think, just like I used to before I used to make these videos, that it's really, really easy to make these things. It was really easy to just grab a camera, speak your mind, and do this. But it's not. And it took me a very long time to figure that out as well. It wasn't something that I just figured out overnight. In fact, if, you know, we can go back to pretty much 2013. In 2013, I was still a chef. I was still cooking. That's what I was doing, basically, all right? And I moved to Seattle, you know, just a better life, you know? I was still cooking it up. That's the only skill I had. I didn't think I could do anything else with my life. I don't don't think, I never thought I was going to be worth anything else except just be a fucking chef, be a cook, whatever. So that's why I ended up kind of like moving to Seattle, you know, simply because, you know, things were falling on hard times. The economy, man, it's really loud, man. I know, you know, sometimes like it's so loud here where I can barely hear myself and it doesn't translate here where you guys can't actually hear me. So I don't know how this microphone shit works, but whatever. But the point is that back in 2013, I was still just a chef. I was still just cooking it up. I was still just living that life. And how the hell did I get from there to here? How the hell was this all done? Now, it wasn't by accident. It actually took a lot of work on my part. Back when I was chefing it up still, I was already like burning out. You know, I was already burning out, especially when I was already living in Seattle. I was already at burnt out mode, and I was just thinking to myself, you know, well, fuck it. Maybe new beginnings, new place, new everything. This should be able to help me get back on the saddle, not burn out, so on and so forth. But you know, the reality is I was just burnt out, you know, not just burnt out by the kitchen, but burnt out by the industry, burnt out by my career, burnt out by life. Like, I'm sure a lot of you guys can relate there. And, you know, long story long, I found myself without a job. After that happened, I didn't know what the hell. Well, how about this? After that happened, At first, I really didn't know where my next steps were going to be. I didn't know what I was going to do in a weird way. Like, I knew the last time I worked in the kitchen, you know, like, kind of like the last day that I was in the kitchen and working, I already kind of knew that after this, I wasn't going to do anything else ever again. You know, meaning that if it didn't work out in this particular kitchen, I'm never going to do this shit ever again. And sure enough, that's exactly how it worked out. But again, it was a series of steps. It was a lot of work for me to get here. And it wasn't like automatic how I just got here. It was just all a mindset that I had to, put in a new mindset within my mind as to how the fuck am I gonna change everything about my life and everything that's going on, and how am I gonna get to this point? I kind of knew that I wanted to do something like this, what I'm doing now. I just didn't know how the fuck I was gonna get here. And, you know, that's where like the whole putting your head down and getting to work came in. So what happened was that like right after I left the kitchen, I actually had a business opportunity with a few friends. And at the end, it was all basically me, you know? So, but I just had a business opportunity where, you know, I just kind of went into business, and long story long, I just kind of became like a business consultant. I was helping other people, with their businesses, with their products. I was doing all kinds of shit like that. I was just doing a bunch of odd jobs, but I knew how to sell myself, and I was in a different point in my life, and I was just selling business. You know, I was just doing like, you know, that restaurant, what's this shit called? You know, restaurant nightmares or kitchen nightmares or, you know, bar rescue type of shit. That's what I was doing. And it was actually going pretty well. All right, hold on a second. Look at this, you gotta be careful here. I don't get all wet. All right, we survived. So I started doing that for a while, and I was doing the business consulting, and it was great. It was great at first, and it was awesome, and I was able to get into other industries as well. You know, I was in Seattle, so mainly, you know, the marijuana business was up there, so I was able to dabble in that. I was able to dabble in a bunch of things, and it was really awesome because I got to do like a bunch of different fucking things, you know, things that I never thought I was gonna do or be able to do. And I did them, and I just did them, but I fucking knocked it out of the park. It was fucking awesome. But as I was getting a lot of money in my pocket, I was also becoming extremely unhappy. I was getting very antsy. I knew that that's not what I wanted to do with the rest of my life. But at the same time, I knew I didn't want to go back to the kitchen. I knew I didn't want to be a slave anymore. So I look at all the traffic. Look at the doggy. Hey, buddy. So I knew I didn't want to go back to the kitchen. I didn't want to be a slave anymore. I didn't want that shit to go to waste anymore, my life. And at the same time, I mean, what I was doing was great, but I knew it wasn't going to last. I knew for a fact that it's not something I wanted to do for the rest of my life. So I was constantly, you know, I mean, fuck it. I mean, I'll be honest with you guys. I was partially depressed because I was getting all this money. I was pretty much had everything I've always wanted my whole life. But the one thing I didn't have was that thing, you know, the thing that I'm doing now, you know, that one thing that I'm always telling you guys all about that we all have to figure out. That thing that helps you wake up in the morning. Before, when I was a chef, I might have hated that shit, but there's a lot of things that helped me wake up in the morning. You know, the fact that so many people depended on me, the fact that I was such a badass and I was able to do so much and not many people were able to do the things that I was able to do, and just so on and so forth. There were so many fucking things that helped me wake up in the morning and do that job. But after a while, you know, after a while, again, you know, that shit will fucking kill you too. It's not, because it's not what I really wanted to do, you know? I was always constantly fucking suffering with that shit. So then the roles reversed, where I was making a lot of money, but I was just as miserable. In fact, even more miserable, because I had less to look forward to. Tight corner here. Uh-oh. That was close. Alright. So, you know, it wasn't going great, but the one thing I did have was time. The one thing I did have was the knowledge that I didn't want to keep doing, you know, that particular job anymore. And so at that point, I was starting to try a bunch of different things. I tried so many different types of jobs and careers, and maybe I can study this or study that. You know, that's when I started getting back into computers, getting back into that life, getting back into the technology aspect of my life, you know, just getting back to a lot of things that I had left behind when I was younger. Subsequently, shout out to Abe King out there, my best friend in the whole world, you know, my fucking brother. You know, he's an artist and he always has his camera, had his, art equipment, you know, for lack of a better description. And one day he asked me, hey, can you fucking help me out? I need to film something, blah, blah, blah. You know how to handle a camera? And I'm like, yeah, I know how to handle a camera. I used to do that shit when I was younger. By the way, my family, when they were younger, half of my family were in the restaurant business and the other half were photographers and videographers. So I kind of already had that shit in my, in my blood. So, all right, let me see if we can cross this shit. All right, we're good. So I kind of already had that in my blood. I just needed to reawaken that. So as soon as that one day he asked me, hey, can you help me out? And I went and I helped him out. I grabbed my camera. I mean, I grabbed his camera and helped him film. From that moment on, I was addicted again. I was like, oh shit, I love this. This is fun. And not only that, but I mean, I'm really good at it. And subsequently, I just kept on going with that, you know, meaning that I immediately noticed right away that not only is this like what I really, 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 really wanted to do with my life, and it was also very, very fun. It was also like just amazing. It was just like an amazing experience. I remember the first times that I was filming things or editing things or what have you, that it was just like when I was a little kid playing with Legos, or a little kid playing a brand new video game, or just like that mentality of me being a little kid again and just not being able to drop it. Like, I couldn't go to sleep. I was always on the computer trying to edit something. As soon as I woke up, the first thing I did was grab my camera. I wanted to go film something. And every day was a version of that. Let me see. Every single day was a version of that. And so, as each day, I kept getting more enthralled by this. I was just like, I quickly figured out, okay, this is what I want to do. Then once I figured out that that's what I wanted to do, which is what you're looking at now, I said to myself, okay, well, I already know what it's gonna take in order for me to get to where I wanna be, which is a lot of work. And now, and then I asked myself, am I willing to put all that work in? And the question, I mean, the answer was easily, I mean, yeah, that question was easily answered with yes, of course I wanted to do this. I figured it out. So then that's when that journey began. And that journey began around 3.5-4 years ago. So around 3.5-4 years ago was when all this began. Because again, as I was looking at the, you know, older videos and all that shit, you know, with my girl last night, I realized it wasn't that long ago. But in that short amount of time, I've already lived so many lives and gone through so many fucking things and adventures that it's pretty crazy, because it feels like it's been 10 years, even though it's only been 3 years. And imagine what my the last 10 years of my life would have, you know, actually is. It's more like 30 years and so on and so forth. I mean, people that really know me, they know I've lived many fucking lives and many adventures and many everything. And so, again, I wouldn't trade it for anything in the world. Sure, I'm out here right now living a brand new adventure, a brand new life without barely a penny in my pocket. But, you know, every single penny that I spent has been an experience, has been a part of my life now, has been something that, like, I'll never forget. Not only have I'll never forget, but I actually got to record it. I got to keep it there. It's like a time capsule for the rest of my life and so on and so forth. And it's just fucking amazing, man. It's just crazy. But I digress, you know, like, I know it's more like story time today, more than Motivational Monday, but the point is that it was very easy to motivate myself because the fear of failing was so great, in the sense of, like, you know, the fear of, like, if I did not find what I really wanted to do in my life, if I did not, you know, figure out that, you know, that this, what I'm doing right now, that I was going to end up back in the fucking kitchen. That I was going to end up back as a fucking slave, and there was nothing I could do about it. So it was literally up to me to make that conscious decision to do what I'm doing now. Because again, it's either this or get back to work, get back to the kitchen. No, muchas gracias, señora. Gracias, gracias. And that's what it was. You know what I mean? That is basically what it was. That's basically what brought me to where I am right now. And I wouldn't trade it for anything in the world, but it took a lot of work and hard, you know, a lot of hard work and dedication, because from the very, very beginning, it was very apparent that I wasn't going to be making any fucking money off of these videos. I wasn't going to be making any money off of my career. I wasn't going to be doing any of this shit. I mean, I'm a fucking professional chef. I'm a professional, a lot of things. So, you know, just, and I'm a Virgo, a bunch of things. So I'm kind of like a bit of a perfectionist. So I knew to myself, it's like, man, it's going to be a while before I can actually sell myself, sell my services, sell this stuff. Because, you know, I didn't feel confident to, you know, start a business or do this shit within, you know, just having a little bit of knowledge. I needed to be, you know, badass. And it took me a while. And so I knew the only way I was going to get there was by working. You know, meaning, like, I had to, like, fuck it, make a video every day. But I had to keep pushing myself. I had to keep challenging myself. I had to keep, you know, keep at it and not ever give up. But what made it easy for me to keep doing that shit was the fact that I actually found something I loved. That's why that's so important. Because since I found something I love, you know, it's always, you know, my battle on a daily basis was more like, man, am I going to make this video or am I going to make money to eat something? And a lot of times I was like, you know what, I'd rather make this fucking video. You follow me? And that kind of mentality, but it's not for everybody. You know, for me, I didn't see it like any other way. I'm trying to find a place with shade so I can sit for a minute. Let me see, I think over here. So, I mean, I didn't really see it like there was no other option for me. I had to figure this shit out. I think I'm gonna sit here for a minute. And I did. And that's basically it. So, the motivation sometimes doesn't come in the way that we think it's gonna come. You know, a lot of times, you know, you have to self-motivate yourself. You have to figure it out. You have to do a lot of work. So a lot of times when I'm talking to you guys out here, I know a lot of you guys haven't done all that work, haven't thought this out all the way through. You guys just see yourself at the end of the rainbow, you know, living in paradise, you know, chilling with your feet up and that kind of stuff. But you don't really put two and two together, because again, you know, living in paradise and living with your feet up and doing that kind of shit, it's pretty good. It's all right for a little while. after a while you get really bored. And so that's why, you know, again, you know, I never get that bored. You know what I mean? If I ever give myself a bit too much time off, I already get antsy and I want to get my camera. I want to go out. I want to record. I want to edit a video. I want to do something and make some art or whatever it is I'm doing. And so, again, that's why this is the most important thing, is literally figuring out and finding what it is that you love, what it is that makes you wake up in the morning and just, you know, want to keep doing that shit over and over and over again. Because, you know, that line that I keep saying about, you know, why starve doing something you hate when you can starve doing something you love? But again, you know what I mean? It's a process to get there. It's a process, you know, for you to, you know, for a lot of work. Hey, look, you want to see a horsey, guys? You want to see a cute little horsey? Look at that. I know. A lot of people don't like these horses because they're... you know, I'm not even going to get into the whole horse thing right now. I'm just trying to see if I can finish this video. I get distracted. You know, Homer, I got to put the Homer thing. It's like, ooh, a bird. But anywho. Anywho's. All right. At the end of the day, guys, you know, my story is not that unique. It really isn't. You know, it's just, it took a lot for me to get to this point. That's why where I'm at now, it's like I can stop for a minute and I can look back and be like, fuck, how did I get here? But then at the same time, it's like, it's really easy for me to, you know, remember and recount how I got here, because it was literally a conscious decision that I made many, many years ago that I wanted to, I didn't know I was gonna end up here in Mexico, and I didn't know I was gonna end up doing this, but I knew that I wanted to live like this. I wanted to have freedom. I wanted to have liberty. I wanted to be able to do what I wanted to do and continue working like an animal, but for myself. I mean, no, I know this story is going a little long, but look, I mean, the one thing that I always suffered with when I was in the kitchens was that I always had this awesome personality, and I was always like, you know, making people laugh and enjoying life and all that shit. But I was always like stuck in a kitchen, and I always like thought to myself, like, fuck, man, this can't be it. I mean, this can't be the top of my everything, because like I'm so intelligent, I'm so charismatic, everything is just so awesome, but yet I'm always stuck in this little kitchen. You know, there's only a few people that really get to see me because I'm in this fucking cave here. I got bosses that are always pieces of shit, no matter even if I was a boss, there was always a boss, and so on and so forth. And so I was always like in hell. I mean, for lack of a better, you know, whatever it is, I wanted to be me 100% and I could never be me. I always had to kind of behave, even though I was in the kitchen and you don't have to behave much there, still a little bit. And now when I'm doing what I'm doing, I get to fucking be me 1,000,000,000% of the time and enjoy it. And when someone says, hey, you should not cuss, I can literally just laugh and tell them to go fuck themselves, because I get to do what I want. You know what I mean? I don't go to their fucking house or job and tell them what to do. So I don't expect anyone to do the same. And when they do, I laugh. Because again, it took me a lot of work and dedication to get to this point. And it's not about, you know, viewers and subs and all that shit. It's really about just me being able to do what I want and showing you guys a bit of my story, a bit of my life, and inspiring others to, you know, maybe do the same or do something similar. And these are the things that get me up in the morning, because again, these are the things that used to get me up in the morning when I was a chef, but now I get to do it on a grander scale, and every single day it keeps increasing and increasing. So it's like a fucking drug. It really is. And it's a drug that I'm addicted to. Which is, you know, you guys, which is this camera, which is, you know, this whole medium and everything that I'm doing here. And I feel so thankful and so grateful that now I get to do this on a daily basis and really enjoy and love what I do. And it's just awesome. I mean, it really is. But it took a lot of work and a lot of heart and dedication and a lot of self-reflecting. And it just took a lot of work to get here. Because again, just going back to my older videos that I used to, you know, make when I was first vlogging, you know, 3 years ago or more, I would look at myself on camera. I mean, I was looking at myself on camera last night, and it's like, that's not me. I remember my friends used to tell me, man, your videos are great. You do great editing, great story, whatever, but like, it's not you. That's not who you are. And it wasn't until I literally lost everything and got to rock bottom. And again, you guys know the whole Texas thing. If you guys want more context, just, you know, write in the comments and, you know, I'll see if I can fill you guys in. But at the end of the day, after that whole situation happened back in Texas 2 years ago, and I went and I lost everything, went to rock bottom in that whole situation, you know, it was my friend that picked me up, the same friend that first gave me my camera, Mr. Abe King, that he lifted me up again, and he fucking told me, hey, brother, you know, get on camera and start talking and being you and telling your story and doing all that shit that you always love, because just do it, you know what I mean? You're driving me crazy with this, so just fucking do it. And since I was at rock bottom and I literally had nothing else to lose, I lost everything, and I was at that point in my life where I was like, well, fuck it, I got nothing to lose. Let me just spill it all out there, that that was what awoke the beast within me and allowed me to really, 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 you know, speak out freely like the way I'm doing now, where again, I got tons of people around me and I'm just telling you my story. I'm not embarrassed or scared or anything like that anymore. In fact, I feel very comfortable talking to you guys in front of the camera while I'm doing everything I'm doing. It's amazing. And it's like, it took a very, very long time to get here, but I'm glad I did. Again, you can just look at the first videos ever. You can just look at the first videos ever that I did when in the crypto space like a year and a half ago, and they're also fucking cringeworthy. And even though these are less cringeworthy, the ones I'm making now, they're a lot better. And I know they're only gonna keep getting better and better because you know what? I'm doing these every fucking day. And I'm not just doing these every day because I wanna build my channel or anything like that. No, it's literally to feed my addiction. That's why I do these every day, because I love doing these. And that's when I knew, you know, now that this moment in time, every single day as I'm doing these things, it's like I fucking know that, you know, I'm living my dream, because I clearly, literally am living my dream. And what is my dream? You know, just talking to you guys, you know, just making these movies, you know, just, you know, continuously challenging myself and creating brand new adventures for myself every single day of my life. That's my motivation now. My motivation is to continue living life, to continue upping the ante. And it's a beautiful thing to get to this point. And that's why I try to encourage you guys to get to that point too, so that you guys can really grab life by the balls and really enjoy it to its fullest. Because otherwise, you know, you're gonna be stuck there for the rest of your life. And I know most of you guys don't wanna do that and don't wanna be in that position, but hey, I was once there, and it wasn't until life, you know, hit me over the head many, many times, and then I made the conscious decision to follow my dream and follow this, as opposed to just getting another job and continuing, you know, the cycle, okay? So, all right, guys, that's it. I'm gonna end it here because, you know, I gotta get going. I got a lot of things I gotta do. I got a shopping I gotta do. I'm here at the plaza. You gotta enjoy life a little bit. I'm already going like almost 30 minutes. You already know the deal. So, guys, wanna give a shout out to all my patrons, wanna give a shout out to everybody out there. Shout out to everyone that is gonna be with me here tonight on BitTube, on DLive, on Twitch, you know, as we do the live stream and as we do the show. Everyone out there that's here with me every single day, I wanna give you all, you know, all the love, all the support, all the hugs. I fucking love you guys to death. Thank you to all my patrons. Thank you to everyone out there that helps me feed Lambo on a daily basis. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I fucking love you guys. And last but not least, don't forget to stay awesome. And please like, please subscribe, please share, and please do those things. They really help the channel out a lot. And seriously, just go out there and figure yourself out. That's the if you want to do one thing for me, don't do it for me, do it for yourself. Figure yourself out, okay? Go out there and really figure out what your dream is and just go and fucking do it. And stop holding back, man. Stop holding back, guys, all right? You guys have the power, all right? I love you guys, and I'll see you guys mañana. Peace.